Hey, I'm Nick, the Turbine Cowboy. First off, I must apologize for not keeping you guys updated. I was recently sent on a trip to attend training for my work, which also happens to be one of the main topics I want to talk to you about today. You may have watched my first video about why I'm doing this channel, and if you haven't, you can watch it here by clicking this link. Today, I'm here to answer your questions about the industry. How much schooling do you need? How much you can expect to make? And lastly, how dangerous is it? These are all questions submitted by you. And if you have others, please comment them below or email them to me at theturbinecowboy@gmail.com. That's also in the description. Let's get started. You guys wanted to know how much schooling would cost. The easy answer, $20,000 to $25,000. But there are some caveats to this. This may come as a shock, but I've never attended a trade school for wind. I have no private education related to wind. So how did I get this job? I found an entry-level job with a company that provided the training I would need to work on these towers. In fact, my colleagues who did attend school said that the training their company provided was more practical to them than a majority of the stuff they learned in school. Higher education is incredibly valuable, and I encourage anyone who can and wants to go for it. If you're like me and $20,000 is more than you can afford, try looking for a position that tolerates inexperience. In the field, we call that a Tech 1 job. Some companies may call it something slightly different, but for the most part, it should be easy to tell they're looking for someone without an extensive background in wind. They can be found nearly everywhere, and not only will you not have to pay for school, but they will pay you to learn your job. Speaking about pay, this is probably going down as one of the most commonly asked questions, so let me try to be as thorough as I can. As unsatisfying an answer it is, it really does depend. I will tell you my experience though, but I want to make the distinction that my experience won't be reflective of everyone's experience. Now for the numbers. As an entry-level Tech 1, I started making $17 an hour. It wasn't a lot, especially compared to my coworkers who had been in the industry for a few years longer, but I worked hard to meet or beat the expectations of my management. Being on time and completing your tasks goes a long way. Before long, I negotiated a $3 raise to $20 an hour, with benefits like 401k matching and health insurance. Shortly after that, I continued to improve myself and became a Tech 2, which came with its own pay bump. The thing I want to drive home here is the whole time I was being trained during this period by my company, and the more I learned and proved myself, the more they wanted to see me succeed. As it goes, the average yearly salary for an entry-level technician is about $35,000 to $45,000. This is all before overtime and doesn't factor in benefits like the ones I mentioned. But as you can see, still, that number can grow very rapidly. The biggest takeaway from this is that without much experience, you can get out what you put in. This also happens to be a perfect segue into the dangers you can expect from this job. Make no mistake, this industry is dangerous, and it can be fatal. This is a topic I will discuss in upcoming videos, but generally, this job is as safe as you want to be. You are given the equipment, the training, and the authority to keep yourself and your coworkers safe. Independence is both a reward and a responsibility in this career. How you use that will entirely determine your well-being. Some dangers you'll deal with every day include working at heights, oil and chemical exposure, and the 34,000 volts buzzing its way through the wires around you. These dangers are very real, and you will be exposed to them every day. These things won't harm you on a day-to-day basis, but it's important to keep in mind that when things go wrong, they can go very, very wrong. That's why it's important to be informed and be ready to use the training and the tools at your disposal to mitigate and potentially respond to something that puts you or your coworkers in danger. In no way is this meant to scare you off, but I want to be upfront and honest that this job is not for the faint of heart. Every day, there are more people working in this field than before. Those who do make it up tower will be part of a niche band of grease monkeys who take care of one another and would stop at nothing to see the others make it home safely, day in and day out. To all the hopeful tower climbers out there, I wish you all the best in your careers, and thank you for watching my video.